So I'm Josh Oxley. I'm the underwater welding instructor, an underwater burning instructor. We're in our topside welding station. I guess we're practicing topside to get them more ready for the industry, be more versatile in the industry. We use oxygen acetylene to cut steel. We also have a chemtane oxygen rig. So this will teach them how to cut, how to grind, how to prep, how to weld it back together. So it's all the skills that we want to work on, and it puts it in a fun environment for them. So once they've got done grinding and cutting their steel, then they'll come in these new booths we built. So we just installed 12 state-of-the-art booths. They all come with their own electric welding generator. They all come with these state-of-the-art, what they call auto-darkening. So when they strike an arc, the lens itself will darken automatically. So this is one of the projects that one of the classes made. It's the space needle with a octopus tentacle wrapped around it. It's one of the better projects. I actually plan on hanging this one up. So outside the main shop, we have our underwater welding tanks. We have two tanks that are 5,500 gallons each. Here's a typical dive station. We have a communications box and a tender always on hand to talk to them. And that communication box allows me to come over here and talk to the divers about their welding.
Yeah, a little fast.
So being that these tanks are 10 feet deep and I have this window here, it allows me to produce a better welding diver, okay? And being able to talk to him, I could tell him what he's doing and how to make it better. So I can adjust his speed, I can adjust his amps, which is his heat, and his work angle. Very good, thank you, sir. You can go back to work.
You're hot, Blue.
What they're working on is what's called a T-joint. So it's two plates welded together, forming a T. They use a 7014, which is a topside rod that we've waterproofed. And we give them as many rods as they need within 6 days of trying, you know, practicing welding. Being that most people come here trying to underwater weld, wanting to underwater weld, they soon learn that that's just the tip of the iceberg. There's salvage work, there's hydraulic work, there's hazmat. There's a number of fields in this industry that you could go and do this career.